make its debut. It will open another chapter in the success story of BMW and then India. Today's press conference will be addressed by Mr. Rudratej Singh, President and CEO, BMW Group India. Rudratej has been on board since 1st of August 2019, and this is the first press conference he'll address as the President. Without any further delay, I would now like to call upon Mr. Rudratej Singh to say a few words. Rudratej.
But I'm actually more excited of the
next 100 years, when I looked at my orientation, I saw the amount of work that's gone in. Firstly, the other thing we don't know enough of, at least consumers sometimes don't know, is that it's an amazing portfolio of brands. If you look at the luxury sector, how we straddle the luxury sector with Rolls-Royce, Mini, Motor Art, and of course BMW portfolio, it's an amazing combination which I don't think I see anywhere else. So we are not only gearing up for the future with our portfolio, which is unique and extremely strong brands, not just products, but also in our services, our technology, which is now really, really taking the next reshape of mobility agenda forward with our consumers. And I'm really, really proud of that. These are the things that I feel really proud of, and it's made me settle in reasonably well and very quickly. I don't feel like I've been here only for a few weeks. I've been here for a long time. And of course, I must also add India's role in the BMW group. And often it's not understood how important India's role is, because we sometimes may look at it only from its point of view and not from its strategic importance point of view. In my understanding, in the 140 plus markets where BMW group operates, there are very, very few markets. In fact, I can probably count them on my hand, where the infrastructure that has been built so deep. So the decisions that we will take to give performance and growth is not going to be knee-jerk. It's not going to be something we do for a month or a quarter. We are here to make sure that we make short-footed steps to grow, but grow profitably, grow comparatively, and grow consistently in all three vectors of growth. The last thing I would say, which is special, and I think this is something I will talk about of when we meet one-on-one or when we talk about it later and will start forming part of our strategy, is the ecosystem we are building. We already have 80,000 plus satisfied customers in India. We want to make sure that we are truly engaged with them. That's the power of BMW, to truly create an ecosystem of experiences that are bespoke, experiences that are exclusive, experiences that money can't buy. And all you need to be part of that is to own a BMW. And I think that is happening already, and we will drive that vector because we have the skill in our company to do that really well. And that's going to be our competitive advantage going forward. Coming to, of course, the main event of the evening, which is the 3 Series. Again, the 3 Series, to set the context, it truly epitomizes across the world, across the 130 plus markets where the BMW 3 Series sells. Over the 40 years that it has been available, it has truly epitomized the sheer driving pleasure narrative. It has a very strategic role in India as well. It is the largest selling ultimate sports sedan across the world. But more than that, even in India, every third car that we sell, and I'm not surprised, is a 3 Series. And really, I must say that 3 Series has an extremely strategic role in our portfolio. It's a very, very strategic role. There are, of course, enough and more customers, and you will see that today, who have enjoyed the 3 Series over six generations of 6 generations that have happened in India. But while we continue to be relevant for our current users and give them the joy of sheer driving pleasure, it also attracts new consumers who love the brand, who haven't chosen a BMW product yet. And not only is 3 Series extremely aspirational and really lives the values of what BMW stands for, it also is a very accessible entry point into the world of BMW. And I think therefore it will continue to play an extremely strategic role in our portfolio, not just to strengthen our segment share, which is what we talk about a lot, but really fundamentally expand the segment. And at some point in time, we have to realize have to get and focus on our consumers who love the brand, who still haven't bought. And when we do that, I can guarantee that even our segment share will increase. It's all linked. And that's where our focus will be going forward. So create delight for users, but also continue to create desire amongst the non-users who are very willing to come in. Earlier, but now it's wireless. I know my daughter loves that idea. So there is something for everyone in the family. Of course, my family's personal favorite is also gesture control. Not only is it cool, it makes you can enjoy your navigation and your music through the gesture control. But I think it has that functionality again of making the driver focused on driving, not having to try to touch the instrument cluster and the panels. We also have now the one of the largest digital displays with 12.3 inches, which also is more integrated now than before. Of course, the soul of the engine will be, the soul of the car is the engine, and the twin turbocharged 2-litre engines are truly special. They always have been special. We will be, of course, in both petrol and diesel choices, which offer a really optimized maximum performance and maximum efficiency, which I think is, again, very, very special. The petrol engine, which I think personally is truly world-class, segment leader, and you have to experience it for yourself, is the most responsive and fastest engine in the segment, which is really fantastic. It's also BS6 compliant. Well, please welcome the all new three.
Let's go for a drive.
Ladies and gentlemen, the pricing I think pricing is, of course, important, and I'm really, really delighted with the pricing that we've been able to put together. But that's not the only part of the story. That we know that in India, cost of ownership is such an important trigger or barrier, if you like. And I can tell you that the way our financial services colleagues, Andre, Catherine, and the entire team, have put together constantly the 360 program, the 360 BMW program, to constantly innovate, has always been pivotal in our success. Even today on the 3 series, we are very, very attractive, very low EMIs. In fact, strategically, like I was telling you earlier, this will almost be at the same EMIs of the near premium owners who are looking at buying a non-luxury car. They would find these rates of EMIs really, really attractive. And of course, very, very attractive rate of interest. And again, very interesting is the buyback value. I think for some, you can go up to, for the 3 series, up to a 23 lakh buyback value, which is, I think, phenomenal. So really, kudos to the financial services team, who are absolutely integral to our plan on going forward in our strategy. Of course, the aftermarket plans on cost of ownership are extremely pivotal as well. The BMW service inclusive is really, really designed to reduce cost of ownership. And I think that, again, really helps different types of customers who have, like I said, different triggers, different barriers for cost of ownership. And I think we have, together, created a very, very compelling proposition. And therefore, there is no reason for people to postpone their joy anymore. And I'm really, really confident that going forward, not only will we attract our current users to upgrade and also segment users to move into BMW, but it's also going to open the segment size, which is, as I said earlier, very, very critical part of our strategy. So really, ladies and gentlemen, joy is BMW, and we will continue to wear BMW. Give joy in India and across the world. Thank you very much, and I look forward to talking to you.